Hi everyone, on this video I'm going to show you how to connect to Snowflake through Microsoft Excel. Usually you'll likely connect to Snowflake to something like Tableau or Power BI or some sort of data viz tool, but perhaps you want to connect just directly through Excel and use that program. And I'll show you how you can do that. So the first step you need to take is to actually download the ODBC driver for Snowflake and install it onto your machine. That can be found if you go to Help, Download, and then it'll take you up here and you can see ODBC driver. And that's what Microsoft Excel will use to connect through to Snowflake. I'm on a Windows machine, so I'll select this one. And here it's going to ask you for, you know, which version, a 32-bit, 64-bit, and how do you know which one you actually need? So I'm going to hop into Excel and I'll show you how to find that. If you go to Account, and then About Excel, click this guy, and up here you can see 32-bit right here. So that's how we know we need the 32-bit option. So back here I'm going to say Win32. I'll get the latest version and save the file. Click that, it's an executable, click OK, and it'll take you through this setup wizard. Next, install. Okay, finish. So now how do we connect? Now it's on our machine. Now let's go to Excel and open up a new workbook. So we have the driver, we have the driver installed, and now we want to allow Excel to use the driver. Now the next step, especially if you're on Windows, is you actually have to add this driver to one of the options for what your computer will recognize. So if we go down here and search ODBC data sources, 32-bit, open this up. Drivers, we can, let's see if we can find it. And here we can see the Snowflake DSI driver, it's here. So if we go to user DSN, let's add a new one and we'll select Snowflake, finish. Here's where we configure it. So now here is where we set the connections to actually go into Snowflake so it knows where it's trying to connect. So data source, let's give it a name. I'll call this Snowflake. User, you'll have to take the user of your, you know, this is just as if you were connecting through, like I said, a data viz tool. You'll take your user and you'll give it an account. You'll have to select a warehouse, role, database, etc. So we'll go user, put your password in. Server, we'll put the name of the URL. We'll put the whole URL in here. Database, I'm going to do this one right here. Demo DB. Staging schema, I'll use this guy here. I'm going to take one of these warehouse, compute warehouse, one we got here. And I'll connect as account admin. Okay. So let's hop back into Excel. And to connect here, we'll go to data, get data from other sources from ODBC. And here's this option now. Before it would not have been here, but because we just configured that, it's now an option. So we'll do Snowflake, click OK. Perhaps I need to get rid of the HTTPS here. Let me go back. Let's get rid of this. And try it again. Oh, there we go, we're in, OK. Here we can see everything. We can see the databases, we can see schemas and all the tables. So let's grab a few. Let's select multiple. Let's do teams, team details, my first model, just it doesn't really matter. And load it up. So now if you've used something like like the tabular cube, or just try to create any sort of model through Excel or Power Query, this should look pretty familiar. These rows are loaded. Let's double click this and we can see the Power Query editor. So we could do some different types of formatting here. I don't know. This is very similar to Power BI as well. You know, it's the standard Power Query editor. You can add different steps to transform this data and do whatever you want to. You add different columns, add conditions. If you hover over it, you can see when it was last refreshed. Now if we go to connections, we can see this connection here. You can set some of these. You can see some of the properties here. We could right click here and say load to. Let's say we want to see a table in the existing worksheet. Let's say, okay. And here we go, we have this now in this sheet. So let's say we want to add, I don't know, now this one here. Let's load this over here. So we can see this one loaded here as well. And at this point, you know, it's up to you to do whatever you want in Excel, play around with the different features and try to customize it, add some more data, and really build this out. So that'll be it for this video. I just wanted to show you how you can connect to Snowflake, and really you could apply this to other cloud databases as well, I'm sure. So as always, thank you for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment, like the video if you found it useful, and I'll see you at the next one.